this video, we'll look into Tableau regression and how we can use it to perform upgrade and other types of validations within Tableau reports across different versions. Before we jump into it, let's actually discuss the problem statement and the prerequisites. The problem statement is as follows. We have a particular report. Let's assume this is the report in question, which is in its set version, which looks a little like this. And this report is perfectly fine, but it's going to go through an upgrade or an update, and we need to ensure that the next version of the report is in sync with this current version. To this end, we'll use Datagaps regression node. The prerequisites here is to, of course, have the Datagaps BI validator and to already have had defined your connection within the suite. I'm going to be using a direct trust connection. You can use the type of connection you would like as well. Once you've defined this, open up a test case creation. And within the test case, add a node called Tableau Regression. Now, within this node, you need to select exactly what the connection you have defined previously, the site ID, and any other specifics that you're looking for. Within this, I want to look at the filter differences as well, as that is something that I want to capture if they are different. And within the comparison options, you will see a lot more specifics that we can cover. Inherently, the application will perform both textual and visual comparison, and we can choose which one is the default. I'll go ahead with text as well. I'll make sure we are covering color differences as well, if there are any. And if there are any differences, those will be highlighted in red with an opacity of 0.4. These are the settings I'm using. You can use the ones that are deemed useful for your specific use cases. The last option is runtime variation, and this is a very cool option that actually keeps track of the performance metrics of the reports. You see, if your report's previous version was, say, loading in about 10 seconds, but the current version takes about 15 to 16 seconds, that's about a 60% increase in waiting time. And so we want to capture that difference as well, as even an upgrade or any other issue that can come up with this has to be captured initially by the QA system itself. And so for that, we have a runtime variation that's going to define what the threshold is before capturing the difference in any runtime. Once we've defined the options of what we need to capture differences between, we need to select which report we would like to go ahead with. For that, I'm going to click on Add View. And within Add View, I have all the specific projects rolled up. Let's go to Sandbox and select Happy Flow Report. That's the one we are working with inherently itself. And within that, the dashboard. We'll wait for a few seconds for the report to properly load in. And you'll see that this is the exact replica, which is basically the version of the report, because we're actually connecting to the live Tableau system and fetching this. This is an embedded report after all. And at this point, we can actually go ahead with the next step itself. But I'd like to take a few seconds to kind of point out a few specifics that are also present within the application. You'll see that if I apply specific type of filters, like say Arizona right there, or subcategory right here, well, while the actual application changes, we have these filters present within our filter section as well. So I can dynamically select if I want to select all the filters, if I want to have selected values, or if I want to parameterize them and write a specific parameter value. Now, as you can imagine, this opens up the gates for quite a few types of test case validations, which we won't get into right now. We'll get into that in a separate video. Or if you have questions about this, you can always reach out to us at datagaps.com. But the basic gist here is that default validation of reports is pretty good. It's pretty fine, and it's very good for bulk use cases. But for some reports, you want to ensure that for every permutation and combination of filters or parameters applied, the report is still valid. The main reason for this is that at the end of the day, reports are inherently an amalgamation of multiple sources. So if one of the sources is inaccurate, well, that one inaccuracy, when you look at it from a zoomed out perspective and unfiltered perspective, can be easily blurred out as a rounding error. However, an end user is going to apply specific filters that is going to exacerbate that error. And that's why we have this particular use case, where if you'd really like to, you can actually parameterize the entire set of categorizations, and there's an entire subsection within the application built toward this called BI DevOps. For more information, once again, feel free to look into the documentation or connect with us. The basic gist here is that I'm going to go ahead with all use cases, because I don't have to go ahead with that test case right now. But if required, we can always make sure that the application can dynamically apply filters as well as validate them. Well, let's click next now. And the next option is benchmark reports. So going back to our problem statement, we want to ensure that before the upgrade and after the upgrade or update, the report is valid. So we need to capture the before state, quote unquote. And for that, we'll just click on benchmark the report. And what this basically is doing at this point is that it's going into the Tableau system. It's authenticating itself. If there were any filters or slices to apply, it would have done that at this point. And it's getting the output of the PDF, which in the PDF form, which is the output of the Tableau system itself. And along with that, it's getting the performance metrics. And of course, any meta report element as well, as we will see. So this is our Tableau report. And before we click run here, so if I run this right now, there won't be any difference because, well, the Tableau report is exactly the same as the benchmark. And so while we wait for this particular report to run, I'm going to go ahead and actually simulate some changes. So while that's running, let's actually get into edit and let's simulate a few changes as we want to kind of show how the product is going to catch these differences. Well, let's simulate a bunch of these changes. Let's say that somebody is going in and is, well, removing one of the filters, applied filters. It could also be that someone is going in and changing accessories into accessory, single, so a name change or a filter name change. That can be captured as well. Let's apply this change on state as well if we have to. We'll just unselect one of the states to kind of show what we're talking about here. And the reason we are doing that is that it's going to result in data changes as well as visual changes, and we want to kind of showcase that. Next, let's actually try to change the size. So there we go. I've actually altered the size of the report as well, moved the visuals around. That's one other thing I wanted to do. And let's say instead of segment, see if we can edit this. Yeah, let's call it subsegment. Okay, so I've done my changes, but before we move into that, you'll see that in this particular case, yeah, everything is fine. It's just that the application is taking a few seconds to load, much fewer seconds to load in, so we might have to capture that. So there's a simple warning there. But apart from that, the report and filters, everything is working as intended. And I am working off the report in the background. That's why there is a warning sign, because this report is being currently edited. If this report was not being edited, it would be a simple passed and it wouldn't have any warning. But because I'm editing the report, it's saying that, hey, we have validated the report, but just to let you know, somebody's editing it as well. So that's why the warning sign is pretty helpful. And now that I've done editing my report, let's actually click publish. All right, the latest version of the report has been published. We can open that as well. And we'll see that our updated changes are now present in the updated version of the report itself. Let's wait for a few seconds for this to load in. Yep, there we go, subsegment and other aspects. And now let me rerun this exact test case. Should probably close this for now. And what's basically happening is pretty straightforward. We are connecting to Tableau once again, connecting to the Tableau and fetching the latest version of the report. If we had chosen to apply filters or say parameters in this case, those filters and parameters would be dynamically applied. And then we run comparisons against both the visual element and the meta report elements like filters. And here we see, yes, the test case has explicitly failed. So the first thing placed in which test case has failed is basically being called out explicitly. Let me actually zoom in. And yeah, it's the subsegment aspect. So we had actually defined segments and subsegments. And the fact that there are a few records which are present, like Illinois, Ohio, which are actually absent within the other report, you'll see that the application can smartly capture this change. But if you remember, we did a few visual changes as well. Those are also being captured within the application right there between the states, as you can see, between both the versions. Since I moved the state graph a little towards the left, the application has captured that and it's calling it out explicitly. Finally, if I move into filters, you'll see that we did apply a bunch of filters to our category and subcategory, and those mismatches are called out right there, the exact mismatches that we did within our test case. Finally, we can once again check that, yes, in this particular way place, the result and the benchmark loading times are exactly the same. So this is not an issue. But if, say, after a Tableau upgrade, your report loading times are increased by 50%, the application will call it out as an issue as well. What we have seen is Tableau regression created for one specific test case. We have an entire wizard where you can just drag and drop an entire set of dashboards and workspaces into the test case creation. And the application will handle both the creation of the test cases as well as running them. The benchmarks, running these test cases, everything can be automated using pipelines and can be easily linked with your existing CI/CD pipelines or DevOps tools as well. For more information, feel free to contact us at datagaps.com.